We're reviving a canceled undercover police program from the 80s and revamping it for modern times. I think you idiots are perfect. You're officially transferred.
Well, where should we report?
21 Jump Street.
I reviewed 21 Jump Street a week before its release. That's right, I got the early reviews for you guys. You gotta check out the movie preview page more often, so I can tell you in advance whether it's good or not. And like I said in the original review, I was surprised by how entertaining and funny it was. In fact, if I had one problem with the movie, it's the title. Aside from the general premise, two cops going undercover to infiltrate a high school drug ring, this movie really has nothing to do with the 21 Jump Street show, which was a more dramatic, sociological look at its high school targets. I think the movie should be a little more direct and confident on standing alone on its own two feet than writing itself off as just an 80s rehashing job. Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum are cops who can't seem to do anything right on the job, but Police Chief Ice Cube finds a place for them in his undercover unit. Their mission? Pretend to be high school students and find out who's supplying a mysterious speed-like drug. But they find a way to screw up their cover already because they don't even know who they are.
Let's do this. Which one of you is Doug? Let's do that again and pretend you guys aren't weird. Which one of you is named Doug?
No, dude, I'm Brad.
Okay, good. So that means your name is Doug, son.
Yeah, I'm Doug.
Now we have the wrong identities, you dumbass.
Oh my God, who cares? I can fake my way through band practice and AP chemistry.
AP chemistry? No, you can't. You don't even know what it's actually f***ing called.
Things get really trippy when they ingest the drug and get stopped by gym teacher Rob Riggle.
Don't blow on me, son.
Guys, don't make me take you to the principal's office.
I don't like that. What are you doing? Put your tongue back in your mouth.
And what better way to show you're legit, throw a party, bring the cool kids over, and watch your back.
When did I get stabbed? That's awesome!
21 Jump Street is in the cheerful tradition of reckless buddy comedies like Superbad and Pineapple Express, and for Channing Tatum, this is a home run. He shows surprisingly good comic timing and is no longer just a pretty boy. The action scenes are over the top without being overkill, but the movie does a good job at avoiding the cliches most high school films linger on. Yes, the showdown ends at prom, but there's no dance or forgiving redemption speech. I wasn't expecting a lot from 21 Jump Street, but I found myself laughing and laughing and laughing. Our next movie is Seeking Justice, another in a long line of disappointments from Nicolas Cage. I used to think it was just bad luck, but the man seems almost deliberate in wanting to pick the worst scripts he can find. Cage plays Will Gerard, a New Orleans high school teacher, whose wife, Mad Men's January Jones, is brutally raped and beaten one night. Will takes matters into his own hands when Guy Pierce, who must have lost a bet to get stuck in this trash, appears as a mysterious figure who offers to kill his wife's attacker. But one day, he might call upon Will for a favor.
Who are you?
I represent an organization that loves this city. We're tired of watching it go to hell.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about. This wouldn't cost you anything financially, but we may ask a favor of you at some point in the future.
So, as expected, Will gets more than he bargains for when Pierce and his associates won't leave him alone. Wow, didn't see that coming. And things get even more unpredictable, I hope you know I said that jokingly, when he gets caught in a murder rap, has to evade the bad guys, can't trust his friends, and protect his wife during all this. The only people who would find this material fresh are people who've never seen a movie in their entire lives.
You have no idea what this guy is capable of.
Where have you been? That I heard you walking around.
And for a guy who gets pinned for murder he didn't commit, whose wife is threatened at gunpoint, whose friends have betrayed him, and whose mugshot has been plastered all over the city's newspapers, Cage seems pretty relaxed and subdued most of the time. How can such talented actors and a skillful director like Roger Donaldson stoop themselves to some low-rent garbage like this? Life is short. I will commend the movie for one original touch. Food products have never been used more intently as a plot device. Pierce tells Cage to go to the vending machine and order two chocolate bars if he wants them to kill his wife's attacker. The camera editing is so clear-cut here that the movie actually tries to generate suspense by seeing Cage press every number to get closer to the bar. Then another character tells someone to wait by the hot dog vendor and buy a hot dog. I never knew hot dogs and candy bars could be used as such lethal plot gimmicks. You know you're in trouble when the last thing an action movie does is give you the munchies. Okay, when we come back, Adam Sandler's got a lot of explaining to do for the crap he's made us sit through.
Shut up!